Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you had a wonderful day. Today's video is part two of my makeup declutter series. I didn't realise quite how long it was going to be, so I have split it into three parts. So you should have already seen part one. This is part two. I hope you enjoy it. If you do, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And let me know in the comment section down below whether you enjoy these declutters. And stay tuned for part three after this one. Okay, so next up is mascaras. Some of these I've had for a really long time. Other ones are completely brand new. So we're just going to go through them. This is the Model Co. Fiber Lash Brush On Fuzz Lashes. I received this in a box. It's completely brand new. I have not used it, so I'm hanging on to this. Then I have a Revolution Amazing Volume Mascara. Bought this fairly recently, so this one is also staying. I am getting rid of the Olivia Hale Volumizing Mascara. It wasn't a bad mascara, but I just don't like the shape of the brush. So yeah, that one is going. This is the Extra Volume Black Mascara Showgirl by Barry M. I have not used this, so I'm hanging on to it. This is the Amplified Eyed Definition Volume and Lift Mascara by Primark. This is really old, so this one is going in the bin. This is the Fuzz Lash Effect mascara. I am nearly finished on this, so I'm hanging on to it until it is completely gone, but it is a fantastic mascara for a pound. This one is my all-time favourite, actually. I am looking out for this everywhere I go. This is by Pur. It's the Fully Charged Mascara. And, I mean, just look at the brush. It is incredible, and I want it forever. But it is a little bit on the expensive side. I think it's like £20, which isn't too bad, but it's a bit more than I'd pay considering, you know, pound mascara. Then I have a sample by MAC. This is the In Extreme Dimension 3D Black Lash Mascara. This is a really nice product, actually, and I like the fact it's a sample size, so it's really good for travel. But look at the brush on that. It's just a nice product, so I do like this one. Then I have a 3D lash primer. I have never used a lash primer, probably will never use a lash primer, so this product is going. Next up is a product I bought last Christmas for when I was an elf at a garden centre. And this is a silver wanded mascara. It's just not great, and I don't go to it at any point. I have sort of swatched it on my arm, you can't really see. But yeah, it's just not that great, so I'm getting rid of this one. Then I have the Bad Girl Bang by Benefit Mascara. This is, again, a sample. I haven't used it, so I'm hanging on to it. I think these ones I have not used. I have an Avon True Colour Wide Awake Mascara. The False Lash Effect Max Factor Mascara. Redial Glamour Lash Mascara XXL, and the One 5-in-1 Wonder Lash Mascara. Again, those are all brand new, so I am hanging on to those. This one I used today, and I actually really liked it. This is the Model Co. Mega Lash Mascara, so I'm hanging on to this one. And this one is the Avon Colour Trend Boost It Mascara, but this is really, really old. I don't actually remember the last time I used it, so that one is going. So I've got rid of quite a few, but I'm also keeping quite a few. But if you think about it, the ones I have used are five, and these are all brand new. So I don't think I need any mascara for a while. Okay, so next up are two sets of eyelashes. These are absolutely gorgeous, and they were only £3 from Primark. These were from Poundland, but I have yet to try them, so I'm keeping both. So next up is eyebrow products. So this is the Brow Coat Waterproof Brow Gel. I have never use this product. I haven't reached for it, so I am getting rid of this product. Next up is the Freedom Brow Pomade in Taupe. I don't particularly reach for it, so I am getting rid of it. Next up is the Gimme Brow by Benefit. I love this product. This one is brand new because I actually got this one in a little gift set at Christmas. So this is a sample size, and then this one is full size. But I love this product, and I will probably not change from using it. Next up is the Fill and Tame Brow Gel by Butanic Beauty. It isn't the right shade for me at all, so I am getting rid of it because it's just way too dark. So yeah, that one's going. Then I have two Wonder Brow ones. Both of these are completely brand new, so yeah, I'm getting rid of these as well. I just haven't used them, and this is my go-to brow product. Then I have the Barry M It's a Brow Thing powder. I have used it, I just don't particularly like it, so again, this one is going. So out of all of them, I've just kept two, and this is an amazing product, I really recommend it. Okay, so next up, setting powders. The first one is by Number 7. I actually had a makeup artist do my makeup, and she swore by this product. She didn't wear it for Number 7. I have sort of yet to use it, but it is a lovely product. So I do need to start using it a lot more. So I'm hanging on to this one. I am getting rid of the Technic Soft Focus one just because it is so messy. I drop it everywhere. I think I've only ever used it once. So there's like full product in there. Next up is the Revolution Lace Baking Powder. It's just a little bit too dark for my face. But it is a nice product. So I'm probably going to keep this one to use in the summer when my face is a little bit darker due to sun. Next up is the Mark powder. This is actually by Avon, if nobody knew. And it is actually quite a nice product. It's quite soft on the skin and doesn't make you look too cakey. So I'm hanging on to it. Then there is the Revolution Pro Press Finishing Powder. This one is very white. So it does make you look very white. So you do have to be careful when using it, but it is a really nice product, so I'm hanging on to it. So I've gotten rid of one. Yay! Okay, so next up is eyeliners. I have a lot. So this one is actually going. This is by Primark, and it's a gel liner. I just don't use it. So yeah, that one's going. It's the same with these two. These are also gel liners, and I just don't use them. This one's by Rimmel. I have tried them, but they're just not for me. And I don't actually know who this one's by, but yeah, they're just not for me. Next up is this Dazzle liner. This is brand new. I've never used this, but it's liquid liner and I'm rubbish at it. So this one is going. I have a glitter liner, which I actually keep for Christmas when I'm an elf. It is a really pretty liner. So yeah, I'm hanging on to this one. Next up is a eyeshadow stick. I don't know why that's in here. But this is brand new. It's by Poundland. I don't reach for it, so that one is going. This is a really old product, actually. This is the Avon Big Colour Pencil. You have white at one end, which is a really nice white, to be fair. And then you have blue at the other end, and that is a vibrant blue. But I just don't reach for it, and it is really old, so that one is going. What's this? Next, this is an Avon. I don't even know what this is. This is a chopstick eyeliner. Okay, it's black. But it's just not something I would use, so this one is going. But it was brand new until I just swatched it on my hand. This one is Laritzi. It's an eye pencil. It's in the shade Night Blue, which I am never going to use. It is a nice colour, but I'm just never going to use it. So this one is going. Another Avon Glimmer Stick Flick Eyeliner. This one is in like a, I don't know if you can see like the pencil part, if that makes sense. Again, another product that I'm not going to use. You can tell this clear out needed to happen. Then we have a Steve Laurent product. This is a precision tip liner. I love his packaging. I think it is absolutely gorgeous. This is completely brand new. I don't even know what it looks like inside because it is new and I don't want to take it out. I'm going to hang on to this one and see if it's something I reach for in the next sort of couple of months. If not, this will be going as well. Next is a the Beauty Crop Wing Woman. Again, a liquid liner, so this is going. Another liquid liner by Ico. This is the I Do Liquid Eyeliner. This looks completely brand new, so this one's going as well. The only two liquid liners I'm going to keep is the Super Cat Fat one and the Super Cat one by Soap and Glory because they are just lovely. I then have a Kohl pencil in brown. I'm never going to use a brown, so that's going. This one is a really old product, so this one's going in the bin. This is the Inner Blink Violet Smoke eyeliner. It's purple, but now it's so old it's now brown. So yeah, that's going. Then these are all black eyeliners, all of which I will use, so I am keeping all of these. This one is white. And looks really nice if you pop it on your waterline to sort of make your eyes pop. And this is the Ink Me Stamp Tattoo by Rimmel London. And it just does little hearts. So I am keeping it purely because it does little hearts. Can you hear the dogs outside? So yeah, I'm keeping these, but I am getting rid of all of these. So I feel like we've done well. Okay, so now we're moving on to primers. I have a friend that absolutely loves primers, so if there's any that I'm not keeping, she is probably going to take them off my hands. So the first one is the PHR Perform Hydrate and Recover Primer. This is by Primark. It is in my project pan, and I love this primer. It's actually one of my favourites, but you can't find it anymore, so I'm keeping this one. Next up is the Max Factor Smooth Miracle Primer. This is brand new. I received it in a box swap with a lovely lightning lass. And I've heard good things about it, I just haven't used it yet. Then I have the Body Shop Instablur Primer. Again, this is brand new, so I'm hanging on to this one. Both the Porefessional ones by Benefit are brand new. So again, I'm hanging on to these. The Green Tea Primer by EE. This is actually a really nice primer. And yeah, it actually smells really nice. So I'm hanging on to this one. Then I have the Mark Primer by Avon. Oh, okay, that one is just a liquid. I'm not sure if that's meant to happen. So that one is probably going to go in the bin because I feel like that one might have gone funny. The next four primers I'm actually getting rid of. Actually, I don't know. Let me test this one out. Oh no, that one's okay. I have a bit of a thing for the texture of a primer. This is the Collection Primed and Ready one. It's actually an eye primer, so that should probably go with my eye stuff. But that's very nice actually. These ones have like a matte texture to them, and I really don't like it. So there's the Revolution Ultra Face Base Primer. So this one is going. The Olivia Hale one from Home Bargains, just don't like it. And same with the MUA Skin Defense with Vitamin E and jojoba, I just don't like it. So they are going. Next up is setting sprays. These are actually my favourite setting sprays. They're by Avon. They're the Mark Prep and Set sprays. And they just work really well to hold your makeup in place. So that's why I have a second one. So I'm hanging on to these. This is the Refresh and Prep Skin Energizing Spray. This is by New Look and it is in my project pan. So if this isn't used up by December, I will be getting rid of it. This one I actually bought recently. This is the Obsession Makeup London Dewy Fix Primer. This does not fix anything. I feel like it melts it off my face throughout the day. So this one is going. I don't like this one. And then last but not least, I have the Studio 10 Makeup Mist Glowplexion. This is a really nice product, so I'm hanging on to this one. Okay, so now we're on to foundations and colour fixing products. So I'm going to start with this one. This is the Lightning Drops by The Body Shop. It's a nice product. The pipette thing doesn't really work that well, but I'm hanging on to it because it is a nice product. These two I bought really recently. These are the Obsession Mixer Darkening and Whitening Drops. Because sometimes it's just not quite right. So I thought I'd buy these. They were £2 each on the Revolution website, so why not? Next up we have this Paul and Joe product. I don't actually really remember what it is. So for that I'm getting rid of it. I'm not entirely sure what it is. But it's going. Next up is the Body Shop Fresh Nude Cushion Foundation. I'm hanging on to this because I haven't used it yet. It's completely brand new. So I'm going to have to test this out and see what I think. I bought the Dermacol stuff ages ago because I saw somebody review it and they said it was fantastic. I just don't like it. It's not a product for me. Next up are two products that are in my project pan. This is the Avon True Colour Flawless Liquid Foundation. I actually really like this foundation, but it's not in the right shade. And the same with the Rimmel London BB Cream, just not in the right shade for me. So they're both in my project pan. Another project pan item is the Stay Matte Rimmel London Long Lasting Pressed Powder. Just not the right shade, but look at that pan. I also have another Stay Matte by Rimmel London. This is the right shade for me. So when I finish the other one, I will be able to get on to using this one. I have the Bourjois City Radiance foundation. I haven't used this yet. I actually found it in my car. I'd forgotten I bought it. So yeah, I am going to be using this very soon. This is the Stay Matte Rimmel London Light Porcelain foundation. I just don't like it. I don't like the way it feels on my skin, so I am getting rid of it. Then I have some little samples that I actually bought online. I have three of the Rimmel London Fresher Skin foundations. I really like these, and I actually have the full size one here. They're all in porcelain, and they're all staying. And then I have the Rimmel London Lasting Finish foundation sample. Again, a really nice product. Rimmel do one of my favourite foundations, to be honest. Then I have a sample from MAC, one from Yves Saint Laurent, and Urban Decay. They're just three samples that I haven't particularly used yet. These two look like they're going to be the right colour for me, whereas this one looks quite orange toned. But we'll see. We'll see how I get on. Next up is the Olivia Hale Foundation in Honeysuckle. This was not the right shade for me at the time, so this one is going. Oh my gosh, this is a really old concealer stick, so this one is going in the bin. Next up is an Yves Saint Laurent Porcelain Foundation. This is completely brand new. I actually bought this after my friend's wedding because her makeup artist used it, and I have not used this yet. I've never opened it, so I'm hoping it's still okay. It looks okay to me, but this was £38, and I have never felt like I wanted to use it because it was the first most expensive product that I ever bought, so yeah, I'm scared to use it. Next up is the L'Oreal Paris BB Cream, 5-in-1 Skin Perfector. Oh my god, okay, that's turned to a liquid, that is going in the bin. Yeah, bye-bye. This one is a new product to me. This is the number 7 City Light Tinted Moisturiser. This is a nice product, and I have been using it while the weather's been warmer because I can't be bothered to put on a full face of foundation. So this one is staying. I have a little card from the Urban Decay foundation that I got. Next up is two of the Ordinary foundations. I have yet to try these, but I'm looking forward to trying them, but they are two completely different shades, so wish me luck. Next up is the Primark My Perfect Colour Longwear Foundation. This is a great product for £5. I love it. And I also have the Collection Lasting Perfection one. I'm looking forward to using this. I haven't used it yet, so we will see how I get on. Last up is the Revolution Fast Stick Foundation. Now, while I love this product, and it is a really easy product, I have quite oily skin, and this just seems to run off my face. Whether I put setting spray or anything on, it just doesn't last. So, for me, this isn't a great product. But if you had, like, normal or combination skin, I feel like you'd be fine. But for me, it just slides right off, so this one is going.